She's such a sigh, you are the one. Satpurusha Bhagavan, Kali Yuga Avatar.
Saira.
Saira.
Thanks, Swami, for having brought us once again for this morning satsang. I would like to bring to your notice a good news. A book under the title Cosmic Consciousness is released by the divine grace of our most beloved Bhagavan, containing our Sunday talks. There are about 20 books published containing our Sunday talks. This is the latest one, Cosmic Consciousness, for information. This cosmic consciousness consists of talks given to Spanish group of devotees, talks on Ramayana, and talks on Mahasamadhi. Mahasamadhi, its importance, its significance, because we cannot take Samadhi as like any other Samadhi. It Divya Samadhi, Divine Samadhi, Samadhi of Bhagavan, something like Shirdi Bhagavan, it is of this. So we have three talks on Samadhi and its importance, and then what is suffering, how do we end suffering. We have got three parts, three talks on suffering, because we suffer for unnecessary reasons. What suffering is it true, all that is analyzed. And then a talk given there in London at the Unity of Faiths conference held in London, Southall Park. And then a talk in Vrindavan Whitefield given to the devotees of Karnataka, the title being Then and Now. Because life has become a question mark. Then when Swami is in our midst, now when Swami is not in our midst is the topic. Two talks on that. And then question and answers from the devotees. And then there is one function arranged in Vrindavan, that is Bhakti Premanjali, an offering of love after Mahasamadhi, a talk given there. And one talk given to South African devotees, another talk to group of devotees from Latin America, and one talk given to Vaisya Bank employees, Banking and Baba, that is the topic. And one topic given to the devotees from Poland, and Ideals of Sai Youth, and question and answer session with youth from Orissa. And then Satsai General Hospital anniversary was conducted there at Vrindavan, Bangalore, one talk given to them. And then we have got devotees from Kerala, media personnel attended that, and one talk given to them. And last year at Sundaram, there was one talk there, Madras, Chennai, and that's also published here. And when Bhagavan said, my life is my message, what does it mean? What are its implications? My life is my message is not a quotation, is not a simple dictum, is not an oft-repeated quote by everybody. It has got something deeper. These are the contents of cosmic consciousness. All the talks, okay sir, leave it sir. All the talks, the Sunday talks and the talks elsewhere, here and to other groups from different countries, from different states in India, have all been recorded, video recorded, and they have been uploaded into the website, saiwisdom.com. SaiWisdom.com. SaiWisdom.com is the website to which all these talks have been uploaded. From that website, printouts are brought, and these printouts are duly edited and brought out in a book form, submitted to the book trust, which publishes with the divine blessings of Bhagwan Sri Sat Sai Baba. First of all, my grateful thanks to Bhagwan for facilitating this project, for all the encouragement given to us, particularly in this process of spreading His divine message. As I said, about 21 volumes or so have been released containing our talks. With divine blessings, we may continue in future till Swami gives us the strength. And in this project, there is one key man by name Mr. Lucky, who is the head of a team of members working for the website. The website has got all the translations of the talks in 12 international languages. And all these 12 international languages, there are people working for the website for each of the languages. Around 60, I do not know. Where they are, we do not know. They do not know each other. But people have been working, because that exhibitionism, that pomp won't be there in Sai activity. All people are working without meeting each other, without knowing each other, silently in this project of SaiWisdom.com, headed by Mr. Lucky. And he is a dedicated man. It is he who started SaiWisdom.com. We thank Swami for giving the... We are lucky enough to have the services of Mr. Lucky to work for this website. Now I request Mr. Lucky to receive this copy this morning as a mark of inauguration, Mr. Lucky. With the divine blessings of Bhagwan Baba, I could visit United Kingdom. Some people call it England. Some people call it Britain, whatever it may be. I was there from 16th to 27th of August. For 10 days I was there. And the topic chosen for this morning is UK is okay in Sai, with Sai. Meaning, I want to share my experiences, what happened there. So, UK is okay. Why should I say UK is okay? Because there are people who put questions like this. Are devotees visiting Prashantalayam? Is it the same strength continuing? Are foreigners visiting Prashantalayam as before? Do you find foreigners there? These are all the questions that we get. When I have gone there, I have seen the UK, number of Britishers attending satsangs. Therefore, I had a feeling UK is okay. That's why I gave the topic for this morning, UK is okay. So I visit countries only to say they are okay, so that I can tell these people here, why do you worry? You are not okay, they are okay. You are not okay, they are okay. Because last summer I had been to Latin America, what you call South America, the Spanish-speaking belt. I visited all those countries, about 7 of them, in the month of May, complete. Of course, 4 are remaining. They are fighting that I should go again. So all those countries, Venezuela, Colombia, Peru, Guatemala, Salvador, El Salvador, Ecuador, all these places I visited. And here, in all these places, Spanish or South America is perfectly okay. Finally, I can sum up this, my friends. Do not misunderstand me. In whole of South America, all the 7 countries I visited, and the latest UK, Britain, in all these countries, nobody has put any silly question. What are silly questions? Are foreigners still there? Is there any fall in the number of devotees visiting Prasanthalayam? How do you feel away from Baba? Is it true that people are in confusion? Is it true that the administration is not proper? Nobody, please, I swear in the name of Swami, all such questions are concentrated in and around us. So we are not okay. We are not okay. They are okay. Perhaps in those days, devotees used to come to this place to charge the batteries of their devotion. But in respect of Anil Kumar, he goes outside to have his batteries charged. My life has become just opposite. When I go there, I get charged and feel so sorry. Why I am not as much devoted as those people? Why? There are people who are strict Baba devotees, strict. I am trying to imitate him now after my return from South America. He doesn't drink even a glass of water, doesn't take a cup of tea without saying Brahmarpanam. I feel very much ashamed because I forget to say Brahmarpanam before the dining table because the dishes invite me immediately and draw my attention. Please, therefore I attend to them, oblige them. But here is a man who doesn't drink water or coffee without saying Brahmarpanam. Where am I? Where am I? I feel so bad about it. So bad about it. And there those people in South America, many people have not seen him. Many people have not come here. What a Himalayan devotion they have. Whereas, is there Baba? What is Samadhi? Are there people? See, perhaps, I personally feel we may need some couple of lives to match them or equal them. Forget excelling them. The same is true with UK also. I gave two talks on my experiences in Latin America or South America, which are already there in the website, under the leadership of Brother Lucky, and which are also printed in books. And this morning, UK is okay in Sai. The reason why they invited me is this. I am not of the age to go on a honeymoon trip. I am not of the age. Because I am close to Bhimaradha Shanti. Bhimaradha Shanti is a celebration that Baba made. Baba celebrated a decade ago, or I do not know, for the people at the age of 70 or beyond. So people close to Bhimaradha Shanti, 70 above, are not of honeymoon age. They finished all the earthly sojourn and all earthly joys. We have completed successfully. Yes. We have lived enough, had enough of these things. And I have not gone there for sightseeing also. What is there to see? The parliament in Delhi is far better than most of the palaces I have seen. Himachal Pradesh is the most beautiful place, the crown of India. No place matches that. And in respect of temples, Tamil Nadu, what a state it is. And in the natural beauty, the greenery, waters, Kerala, wow, paradise of India. So there's nothing for sightseeing anywhere. And if we want to go for sightseeing, everything is here in India. So what I want to make it clear is, I have not gone abroad for sightseeing, and I have not gone any time before or in future as a pleasure trip, certainly not. Only to spread his message, that's all. To meet his devotees, that's all. Nothing else. Everywhere they were asking, Anil Kumar, do you like to do shopping? I said, what for? I have no place to live in there. Why shopping? Why shopping? What shall I do? Or should I start some other stores? Our sales counter. And no, shopping is not necessary. And some people say, shall we go for a picnic? Not necessary. They say, what do you eat? I said, I can manage with whatever you give. I can manage. What? If some puris or chapatis will do, that's all. Don't worry about my food. Don't worry about it. So food is not important. Sightseeing is not important. Pleasure trip is certainly not. So my deep desire is only to spread his message. I said on many of the platforms everywhere, I want to live for this purpose, nothing more. Nothing more. Live for Sai. Live for Sai means what? The field that is dear to me. The field that is close to me. The field in which I am fit enough. Supposing you want me to construct a building, I am unfit. Supposing you put me there in the accounts office, finish. I am not fit there. So I am fit enough here. And Baba designed me like that all these 43 years. So let me do it. So I want to live for this purpose, to spread his message. Live only for that. Because there is no other attraction at this age. Truly speaking, nobody wants us. This is pakka truth. Though it's very difficult to accept. Children are grown up. They want to be independent. Though they don't say on the face because of Indian ambience. In India, parents don't like son telling, oh well, leave it to me, I can manage myself. Father feels suicidal. So it's high time that we realize that children be left to themselves. They want to be happy, they want to be independent. And unnecessary advice is an interference, brings a gulf between us and children. Leave them, please. We'll be very happy. Let us not be bothered about their accounts, about their interests, bank rates. How are you bothered? If they run short of money, we are not prepared to send them money. We don't have enough to send like that. Therefore, I have no charm of life, I tell you. No charm, there's no beauty also. What is there? Sunrise, breakfast, lunch, snack, again dinner, that's all. What is the charm in life? There's nothing. But the charm and the beauty lies in living for Baba. In living for Baba, because there is a goal, there is a purpose, there is a beauty, there is a joy, there is a thrill, there is a bliss. That's why we pick up interest to live. Or else what? There is nothing other than speaking about the sons-in-law of our families, daughters-in-law of our families, sons of our families, how many buildings they constructed there. They constructed their 5 buildings. Here you are living in one room. Why do you boast of them? Sir, very silly. There cannot be greater joke than our own selves, our own lives. Some people come and say, my son brought, Ankur, my son bought a car. So what? You are just walking, I see you. Then why do you say that? Some other fellows say, my daughter purchased 5-bedroomed room. Okay, you don't have even one room to roll on the floor. Why do you say that? Therefore, my friends, is enough is enough. Let them be happy. We pray that they should be very happy, that Swami should continue to shower his blessings on our families. And we'll do well by our non-interference. I was talking to my friends yesterday. Vairagya, detachment, is not to run away from the family. Anybody can do it. Supposing if I take bank loans heavily, when I can't pay back, what do I do? Vairagya, run away from the family. Or when I'm fed up with the family people, the wife and the children, no one cares for me, then what do I do? Vairagya, run away. It is not that kind of vairagya. Non-interference. Non-interference, please. Seek out your own path. Go away in your own way. Very good. Non-interference, we should practice right from the family level. Then we can certainly be closer and closer to Vairagya someday, which is essential for a spiritual life. And now, my friends, the theme of the there in UK, they held conference, national retreat. The theme of the conference is Divine Light. This is a souvenir published. Divine Light. I should also tell you another thing. When any person coming from Prashantralayam is highly respected, highly valued, because he is coming from Prashantralayam. Currency notes from the Reserve Bank. You don't need to doubt whether fake notes are not. Don't worry. From right from. We are highly honored and respected. Our duty is to live up to that expectations. If I don't live up to that expectation, well, it is a shame on me. It is a shame if I don't live to that standard. Therefore, anybody from Prashantralayam, something great. And that too, most of the people have seen me standing by the side of Swami, translating for 22 years. They treat as if I am an angel. I know I am not. I know I am not that fool yet. I know my limitations. It is all the glory, reflected glory. If moon thinks I am shining, he is a fool, number one. It is not moonlight, it is only sunlight that falls on the moon, which is reflected. Moonlight is not original, sunlight is original. Therefore, sunlight brings us glory and delight to everybody, not our own selves. I am highly conscious of it. More than the times that my heart beats, I know pretty well that is all the reflected glory, but not personal. Therefore, I am treated as VIP, 1000 V's, you can say that. Very important person, oh, coming from Prashantralayam, Swami is coming. Whenever they say, thanks to Swami, it's all because of you. Or else, no, where I know. Even this crossroad people don't identify you, I know that. Therefore, the kind of reception, the hospitality was so beautiful, excellent and grand. I don't think any bridegroom would be treated like that. The kind of treatment according to me is equal to Prince of Wales of UK. Yes, like Prince Charles, like that. Oh yes, few sevadal behind, few sevadal in front, and number of people with cups of coffee and breakfast. Wow! At home, who will supply? You have to make your own coffee, heat it and drink it, or throw it if it's not tasty. But there, wow, sir, that is Sai. That is glory of Sai. How they treat the devotees, how we should treat them, because it is Sai in them that makes them treat you like that. It is Sai in you who commands respect like that. Sai in them that respects you. Sai in you that commands respect. That's all, nobody. That's my most sincere feeling, believe me or not. So, it is a place close to Manchester in UK. Manchester is known for textile industry, equal to our Coimbatore here, textile industry, Manchester. Textile industry or something like Surat, Gujarat. And it's a place close to that, about 2 hours drive from there. Almost like a village, but with many hotels, lovely hotels. And a big hotel, number of series of hotels. One thing that made me very happy was in UK, this is my third visit. All these three visits, I noticed one thing. They love ancient culture. They love ancient tradition. They want to preserve ancient buildings. Supposing a building of Elizabeth era, they keep it like that. People live there. They maintain like that, paint like that. The old architecture is preserved, protected, sustained, about which the British people feel proud of. It's really marvelous. Nobody thinks of demolishing it. Construct some multi-floored flats there so that people will fall flat in front of those flats. That flag culture I have not observed. Our old buildings, that is there. And then it seems, in those old buildings, which are well maintained, perfect, even to change the color of the building, they have to take permission from the government. Because that uniformity should be maintained. I was very much thrilled to notice that. And then I went there. Just it is located in front of a huge river, river, road and hotels. And the central hotel is a royal hotel, its name is like that. So we are not less than royal, why not? We stayed there and I was given some top floor. Through the window I see the water. Oh, water everywhere. And then nice road, lawns on both sides, green lawns completely. And we find people going for walks on a sunny day. When there's some light and sunlight, they are very happy. Well, we can export some sunlight to that area, that's what I felt. We have excess of light, so we should supply them also. So people go for walks and they go for jogging, whatever the age is. I liked it very much. That psychology. Nobody says I'm old and I'm waiting for the end of my life. Even 70-year-old man looks, why not? I'm going, okay, I'm fine. That's very good. Because we should know the value of life. There's nothing like saying I'm an old man, I'm finished, I'm done, what is it? You don't have to say you are finished, your face tells you. And we don't need to say the end is approaching, it will approach even without your choice. Why? There's beauty in life, there's glamour in life, there's a glitter in life, there's pleasure in life. Why can't we live our own life? When we start living for others, it becomes miserable. When you live for your own self, it is nothing but bliss. What is that self? Living with God. That's what Baba said. Living with God is true happiness. That God is our most beloved Bhagavan. So, and that big hotel owner is Baba's devotee. First class. The Britishers are very particular of their dress. Even for jogging they go well dressed. They never neglect their dress. Pakka. That also I liked. Why? Because we are brought up by British people. The British were there here in this country for 200 years. 200 years. Therefore most of the India is after the British time. Our education, our court, our posts and postal system, railway system is always British. So nobody in India would like to be shabby. No. We don't wear jean pants and go to the college. No. We don't go to office without combing our hair. We'll be well dressed, yes. And those people well dressed going for jogging and all that, very nice. And this man, close to 70 or so, first class, breakfast, morning darshan, I used to have his darshan. Pakka well dressed. It's so nice to look at a well dressed man, fresh in the morning. If we see an ugly, sorrowful face, the whole day will be miserable. See, it's a shame to look at those faces. That man was quite smart. Hello, Mr. Alkumar, how are you? It's a pleasure having you in our hotel. I said, it's equally my pleasure to stay in your hotel. And it has got a big hall, and that hall is well decorated with Swami's picture, well carpeted with chairs all around. So that's a bhajan hall, meditation hall. And it is attended by 600 people. And out of 600, I can say 400 or even more are young people. Youngsters, unmarried or just married or with a child or so. Youngsters. That makes me very happy. Because they are going to be the torch bearers of Sai organization. They are going to carry the banner of Sai organization nook and corner of the globe. So I was very happy about it. Many of them youngsters, they were all given accommodation. And in the morning, they had Suprabhatam, Nagar Sankirtan. Afterwards, those who are interested in yoga will go to yoga classes. Those who are interested in gymnastics, they will go to those classes. Those who want to walk along the beach, along the water, sea water, along the beach, they can go there for jogging and enjoy. Beach ride or walk along the beach. So nice, you see. So all we find groups of people scattered, and then we have got the regular meeting there. Adjoining this hotel, there is a big community hall, a very big assembly hall that could accommodate at least 1,000 people. Very big stage, well decorated. The highlight of this is this. As the back curtain or backdrop from that end to this end. Huge backdrop, flexi, replica prototype carbon copy of Prashanthi Nilayam. Exactly. You also see Samadhi there. You also see chairs and people sitting there. Our own people, same. You feel as if you are transported to Prashanthi Nilayam. There is nothing short of it. Such a huge screen. Wow. I thought, Swami, you are here. Wonderful. Yes, wonderful. We feel your divine presence and the divine vibrations. I thank Swami for such a wonderful decoration. Huge dais with the blue carpet all over. The height. It's the steps on both sides. Carpets and chairs. Men and women. And boys and girls sitting in the front. Separate. And bhajans. Wow, wow. That was the meeting venue. And they were discussing on certain topics, the theme being divine light. I addressed that gathering twice, and in between they asked me also to speak human values, and I also speak our role in Sai organization, Sai mission today, and Sai as eternal charioteer. Certain of those topics I spoke on both the days, both morning and evening. It was thrill and excitement to find youngsters and all that. And singing, I tell you, the music in UK by youngsters, boys of a very high standard, instruments, what a wow. It's something like our Prashanthi boys singing there. Prashanthi Nilayam transported, hijacked there. That's all. Nothing less than that. Nothing less. You don't feel a stranger at all. And after the break, they had sessions, some discussions on peace, dharma, satya, ahimsa, different groups. Each group comprised of 200 people or 300 like that. They were discussing on these topics. Detail. What is peace? Why peace? Why is it missing? What does Baba say about peace? What should we do about peace? Detailed discussion. Not what Baba eats, what do you eat, what is his last word? She. Really, I am just measuring where we stand. What is that standard? Where we stand, a detailed discussion on human values. Very young fellows. I was very happy. They are more informed than most of us. I am reminded of one experience a couple of years ago. Swami was watching a program there in the Sai Kulund Hall, sitting there. That morning at the college, something had happened. What? I used to take classes for postgraduate students on awareness. Well, MSc students, MA boys, MTech boys, they're on the class. Awareness. In that awareness class, we link our subjects with Swami's philosophy. We link our subjects with our scriptures. That morning I was to give a talk. But one boy came and said, "Sir, today is our chance. In fact, I prepared, got up at 4 o'clock in the morning, made preparation. I don't go to any lecture without preparation. If you go without preparation, you have no respect for the audience. You do not honor your audience. It is not a coffee hotel to simply like that and speak whatever you like. You should feel responsible, because all the audience are the gifts of Bhagavan to you. Bhagavan is listening to you. That with that respect one should speak. Therefore I was ready for my awareness class. That boy came and said, "Sir, today is our chance." I said, "Come on, you do it." He is a boy of M.Tech class, Mathematics and Computer Science, by name Sri Ram. Today he is going abroad, number of countries. Very intelligent boy. He got only 4 gold medals, all the period of his stay. "Are, come on, you do it." He spoke on computer science and Bhagavad Gita. Vare, wow! That is the miracle of Baba. Because we have dropped the Bhagavad Gita in ocean, and we are in the name of devotion, we are in Bhagavad Gita. No. The world is projection. Creator is the subject. So, creator, creation, object and reflection, both are same. That's why in awareness class, we link our material sciences with spiritual topics. So he spoke on awareness, computers, Bhagavad Gita, of a very high standard. I was very happy, ecstatic. Almost jumped and danced all around. Because we don't expect boys to speak like that. I congratulated him profusely. And that evening I sat there. Our Swami is divine inspirer, he inspires people. His Swami from a long distance, come on. By his side was sitting Director General of Police, Andhra Pradesh at that time, and some VIPs. Now Swami said, "Tell me what happened this morning, so that they will also hear how great his institution is, how great his boys are." That possessiveness is there in Swami, because he is in a human form. What happened this morning? Swami class in awareness what happened. Swami awareness class. Then I thought of this, Swami, today is my class actually. A boy came and said, "It's our turn," and he started speaking. I see. What was the topic? Swami, Bhagavad Gita and computer science. Who spoke? A boy, Swami. How was the talk? Excellent, Swami. Far, far higher than what I would have done myself with all the preparation. Because they are your boys. I am a stuff from outside. Well, these are your boys. Therefore, they are of high standard. I am very happy. Then he looked at the VIPs and said, "Yemi, do you hear what he is saying? Do you hear? Yes, Swami. What is he saying?" He wanted them to repeat again. "Swami, they are your boy speaking." How proud he is, really, naturally. Now he's quite natural. That is, "Swami, your boy." Okay. Then he called that boy, come on. And materialized a chain for him. I felt as if 100 chains are given to me. A father feels happy when his son comes up in life. A teacher feels happy when his student gets recognition, when he is famous, when he is reputed. Similarly, in UK, I saw number of our old students, at least 30 to 40 of them. Many of them are happily married, 1 year, 2 year old children. Another, he was our first year student. When did he complete post-graduation? When did he complete PhD? When did he come to UK? Where from are these children? Really? I was amazed to see them. I feel as if they are in my class. Today, sir, I am PhD, sir, Oxford University, sir,
Cambridge or Harry, what is this bridge? Cambridge, yeah. Where is it? I was wondering. But I was very happy to see our own children. It means time passed like that. Time rolled is like that. Time is God. Time is God. And they were discussing these topics. Peace, righteousness, truth, above, going deeper and deeper into the topics. I was extremely happy. This happened on 18th and 19th of August. Conference on the Divine Light, the theme. And then 20th of August, I visited a place by name Oldham. Oldham is a place in UK. And I stayed with elderly couple there, elderly couple, with their son and daughter, very happily settled, with very high qualification, whatever. And I stayed with the elderly people. They were very happy to receive me. As the Swami is visiting their house, my brothers, without Swami, life is a garbage, waste paper, dustbin. That's all. The whole value, the respect we have, it is because of Swami only. I can repeat this 1,000 or 1,000,000 times. Or else you go as an individual, you know where you stand without Him. Therefore, elderly couple, with children settled highly there, very big house. And with every family, the first lesson taught to me was how to operate the taps in their bathrooms. Each house has got its own tap design. This way or that way, that way. And unknowingly, if you do that, hot water will just, the skin will peel out. Or ice cold water. So first lesson, go to straight bathroom. Understand tap technology. It is quite hard. If you don't do it, you are running into the risk. And they gave me Sanil Kumar and all, elderly couple, walking up and down. A big gala thing. After all, one fellow stayed there, just one night. And that said, please, Anil Kumar, tell us what Swami say about it. And the gentleman, he said, Anil Kumar, when do you have your coffee in the morning? I said, as early as possible. But time, they said, okay, 6:30. 6:30, I opened the gate. Door, I saw man, full suits, ready. 6:30. Whatever, that is the British. That is the British. I was happy. And after some time, then after breakfast, we had a talk there in their hall. They invited some of their friends. I was talking to them. What wonder, deeper. They were holding books. Swami Abhedananda, Swami Akhandananda, Bhagavad Gita, so many books. And from those books, they were asking me questions. So you cannot tell me one day I got up in the morning, I got the dream, Swami appeared in my dream. Stop nonsense, nothing doing. Or I cannot say Swami car stopped there in the hostel, I spoke to Him, Swami said what happened. That's all nonsense. It's all spiritual topics, spiritual questions. These are the questions I have. You will understand the depth of their philosophy, depth of their understanding. How superficial we are. We are just superficial. Speaking of our own dream experiences, speaking of our own interviews which are questionable, we don't speak of general things which are applicable to everybody, which are secular, which are global, which are cosmic, which are eternal. Depth of spirituality. Therefore, they were asking me and I could have a nice time. On the previous night, after the conference, I had been to another house. That gentleman called his son and daughter-in-law, grandchildren, everybody, all relatives, because Anil Kumar is coming for dinner that night. It appeared as if some marriage function or something going on. Very good. Very good. Because they want to hear about Swami. I want to speak about him only. And then at the end, what happened was, without asking, at the end of the dinner, all people came and sat there. All people came and sat there. Children, elders, everybody, all people, they sat there. And then they were listening to me. I said, what do you want? Then they said, no. Okay, I'll take out. Don't worry. Without this, it is much better. Because the stand is not standing like most of us. Hari Om, sir, let it sit, the stand sit. I'm comfortable in this, thank you. So it's all right, don't worry. So they were all sitting there as a family gathering. Anil Kumar, just 1 year child, please bless. 6 months child, my daughter-in-law, please bless, like that. And then tell some questions. I was very, very happy. My experience is, the most blissful moments in life are those spent in the company of Sai family. The happiest moments are those spent in the company of Sai families. Nothing else. The most interesting moments are those when we speak about him. That's my experience over these 40 years of my life. Then, on 21st of August, I had been to another place, Leicester in UK, where our Dr. Kishan Gadia stays. He is known to many people, Dr. Kishan Gadia. Gadia is a very big, Gadias are a very big family with 500 people. Spread all over the world. The Dhiru Gadia is the senior most man who left us last year. Very famous man. And his brother is Kishan Gadia, who stays in Leicester. Leicester, that evening I gave a talk. Natural. And then at the end of the talk, an international lady by name Rupa, she gave a presentation on sitar, Sai bhajans on sitar. Wow. We are transported to the other world, Sai bhajan. You don't feel like sitting, that's all. We respond, the head goes on nodding, swinging like a flower by the touch of the wind. Because we are not stones to sit like that. Music is a vibration. Music is energy. And that girl, Rupa, is Swami's devotee. She gave a presentation in presence of Swami few years ago. Actually, at the conference itself, near Manchester, she gave a program. And she came to me and said, Uncle, you are coming to Leicester, where I stay. I said, I'll come to Leicester if only you give another program. Oh, why not, Uncle, I'll do it. She came and did. The interesting thing is, though she is an international artist, very, very, very humble, down to earth. Down to earth. Sairam sir. As Baba says, a mustard seed, weight of talent is enough to have pumpkin size of ego. That's what he says many times. I only translated. Ego, pumpkin size. Talent, mustard seed. She has got pumpkin size of talent, not even mustard seed size of ego. Total, because Baba, that is the qualification of a Baba devotee. If there is ego, he is not a devotee. He only says, I am a devotee, but not so. If I say, I am the president of India, what do you say? He is a mad fellow. I cannot say I am president of India. If I say that, I am a mad fellow. Similarly, if anyone says with ego that he is a devotee, he is a mad fellow, number one. Humility is the first sign of a Baba devotee. Because Baba himself is humility in a human form. Baba himself is all humility in a human form. When if you and I are egoistic, it is a shame to our God to have such devotees. I was so happy to see that Rupa, an international artist, there Lester, she just on sitar, Sai Bhajans, wonderful, wonderful. And then 22nd of August, I visited a place, Bristol in UK. As most of my friends here know, that I belong to Brahmo Samaj, a religion founded by Raja Ramohan Roy, who hails from Calcutta. Both of my grandparents are Brahmo missionaries who have spread Brahmo Samaj. Paternal grandfather in Godavari districts, maternal grandfather in Guntur district. Both of them are highly knowledgeable in English, Telugu, Sanskrit and Bengali. Both of them had training in Calcutta, Brahmo Samaj training. They sacrificed their life for Brahmo Samaj. They condemned casteism totally. They condemned all rituals. They condemned idolatry. They believed in unity of religions. And they were not accepted by their own parents. Women are not supposed to have high education. No. Women should get married at the age of 8. That was the situation. My mother was the first lady graduate from Andhra Pradesh. Later she did her MA in English from Madras, that Queen Mary's College, and got gold medal in English literature. Because women were condemned to study in those days. And they just removed all the sacred threads around them. They never visited any temple, nothing, against idolatry. Only they followed Upanishadic teaching. God has no beginning, has no end. God has no birth, so he will never die. All religions are equal. God has no name, has no attributes. That is the Upanishadic standard of religion. They followed, they gave their lives. My parents also are followers of Brahmo faith. I am only fellow who walked from Brahmo to Baba. And I feel that I am a better Brahmo today after coming to Baba. Better Brahmo. Brahmos have disowned me long back. A useless, worthless grandson of two Brahmo missionary series, a fellow who is running after Sai Baba, a human being. They may feel ashamed of me. They may discredit me for that reason. But whether they believe or not, I am a better Brahmo today than ever before. In the presence of Swami, I am telling you, I don't have faith in rituals even today. Even today. I have no caste system. I have no rituals. I still believe that all religions are one. I still believe God has no form, has no name, has no attributes. All those things that Baba says will appeal to me immediately because of that Brahmo background. That's why I'm easily able to mix with all Christians. I go to church. Oh yes, why not? I accept all religions. So that Raja Ramohan Roy, the founder of Brahmo Samaj, died in Bristol, England. He died there. I wanted to see his tomb, where it is. I requested the organizers, let me see the tomb, Samadhi of Raja Ramohan Roy. They said, sir, we are reading your talk, reading your lectures. We read Sanasaradi, where you mentioned that you are a follower of Brahmo Samaj. So we arranged a lecture in Bristol so that you can see his Samadhi also. I thanked them profusely. In the morning I went to see Raja Ramon Rai Samadhi. They said, why? We'll show you his statue of Raja Ramon Rai, there in Bristol, England. I went there straight. There are four roads, wide roads, like a cross. There is a parliament type of building, what they call council hall, very, very big one, huge, attractive. The other side, very big church, four roads, crossroads. At the center, a very big platform of 10 feet. Over that, 10, 12 feet, statue of Raja Ramon Rai, full size, life size. I felt proud of my country. I felt proud of Raja Ramon Rai. I felt proud of Brahmo Samaj. I felt proud of my grandparents and parents. I don't know what reason, tears started rolling on. I don't know. I went there, Raja Ramon Rai standing like that, holding a book. In front of Council Hall at the center. I don't think in Calcutta we have such a building for, such a statue for Raja Ramon Rai. I was telling our Bengal brother, sir, I want to go there and see that. And there it is written, inaugurated by Viceroy, the statue made by a sculptor from Calcutta and biodata given. And other side of the road, a very big statue of Queen Victoria. Queen Victoria, meaning Raja Ramon Rai given equal status of Queen Victoria. What more you want? Green lawns everywhere, beautiful flowers, waterfalls. Wow! I thought, I just, because of the Hindu culture, Indian culture, I went close to him and touched that feet of the Raja Ramon Rai, offered my respects on behalf of my grandparents and parents, thinking of them. Then immediately a thought came to me. He is against idols. Ramon Rai is against idols, idolatry. What foolish thing I am doing, I am touching his feet. So PhD in foolishness. Not merely degree, PhD. Chacha, it's all right, it's all right. In loving memory, all right, let me think. If it's not worship, in loving memory, we touch the feet of elders. It doesn't mean he's an idol, no. Just as respect. I consoled myself, supported my foolish act of bowing down before his feet. Then they said, we'll take you to his Raja Ramon Rai tomb, Samadhi. I went there. Number of Samadhis, number of tombs there. Here we don't visit Samadhis, here in India. If anyone wants to say, I want to go to Samadhi, say, Aray, you want to enter there? Why? There are more beautiful things, there are restaurants, clubs, why do you go there? There, the cemetery, what they call Samadhis, burial ground, they charge at the gate. Like museum, very well maintained. Beautiful gardens all around. And on the Samadhi, they put a beautiful tablet or epitaph giving the biography contribution of every man. It's a site like museum, you pay money and go there. So I went very close to the entrance. There's a raised platform. On the raised platform, there's a well-built Samadhi of Raja Ramon Rai. On that, a beautiful temple-like construction. And there on this epitaph, it is written, good poetry, because English belongs to British people. Yes, English belongs to them. And poetry, beautiful poetic sentences. Raja Ramon Rai contribution to cultural renaissance of India. A scholar in 13 languages, a reformer, man who fought for unity of religions, all those things are written there. First time in my life, I requested our friend Saray, make a video of the whole samadhi, including those letters. And those brought bouquets for me to keep on samadhi. The whole video is taken of the whole thing. I was, up in the heaven. Immediately from there I sent emails to my brothers and sisters. They said, you are very lucky. Why don't you write an article so that all Brahmos will read that? I said, it's not that my feeling. I also had a feeling while going close to that samadhi of Raja Ram Mohan Roy. I was feeling that my parents and grandparents up in the heaven are blessing me, showering their flowers, offering their bouquets to Raja Ram Mohan Roy Samadhi. Because to be religious is a fashion today. To be religious, to belong to a religious organization is a business today. It is a status symbol today. But in those days, to be a Brahmo, it is a sacrifice. It is a crucifixion. Your own parents disown you. I was reading SSLC class at that time, 1957. I attended one wedding. And there was talk there inside. These fellow parents, grandparents are Brahmos. Serving him food in the veranda. In the veranda. I attended one puja, Sri Ramanavami celebration. There they said, his parents, grandparents, they don't observe rituals. Don't offer him food along with us. Serve him in a plate in the veranda. When I faced that, what about my parents and grandparents? They were treated as untouchables. So religion means not a fashion, not a banner, not a business, not commercial. Spirituality means sacrifice. Carry the cross with you. Come on! In the earlier days, in 60s, late 50s, early 70s, people are afraid to say, I am a Sai Baba devotee. You know that? People are afraid to say that I am a Sai Baba devotee. In early 70s, late 60s. Why? Because they come to Anantapur, come to Dharmavaram, and reach, and every fellow says, what is there, what is there? Why do you go there? Such things we had. So, to be a devotee, there is no problem. And today, if we say you are Sai Baba devotee, you will have good business. Oh yes. If you say you are a Sai Baba devotee, your children will be married to very good families. It is a status symbol, dignity, but it's not like that. Therefore, Bristol is a blessing to me. And then 23rd of August, I had been to another place, Stanmore, where I gave talk, and London. And 25th, I gave another talk, Harrow, London. Like this, we had so many talks spread over 10 days, which will be put in the website, God willing, at the earliest. And then, you can also visit sachasai.org.uk, sachasai.org.uk, to have all these talks and the pictures taken over there. And I am also, as I told you, the youngsters have taken leadership over there, and the research they are doing on Sai literature is most interesting. The question answers I have had, we'll have it in the next talk. Thank you for your gracious presence. May Bhagavan bless you. It's indeed you made the day. Thank you very much. Sai Ram. Asato ma sargamaya tamaso ma yodirgamaya mrutyorma amrutangamaya. Om samasta lokah sukhino bhavantu, समस्तलोकाः सुखिनो भवन्तु समस्तलोकाः सुखिनो भवन्तु शांति 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 जय बोलो भगवान श्री साई बाबा जी की थैंक यू वंस अगेन
श्री सच साई यू आर द वन सत्पुरुष भगवान कलियुग अवतार Shri Satya Sai, you are the one Satpurusha Bhagavan Kali Yuga Avatar Satya Dharma Shanti Prima Satguru Shri Sai Nata Kali Yuga Avatar Krishna Shiva Shri Sai Shri Satya Sai you are the one Satpurusha Bhagavan Kali Yuga Avatar Satya Dharma Shanti Prima Satguru Shri Sai Nata Yuga Avatar Sai Ram
Shri Sai Rama
Sai Ram
Satya Sai
Sai Ram
Shri Sai
Rama Krishna Shiva Shri Sai Satpurusha Bhagavan Kali Yuga Avatar